Hello everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. Je voudrais commencer aujourd'hui avec quelques mots sur les nouvelles concernant la gouverneure du générale du Canada, Julie Payette. Tout le monde mérite un milieu de travail sain et sécuritaire, et ça inclut les gens qui travaillent fort dans l'équipe de la gouverneure générale. C'est quelque chose que je prends très au sérieux. Hier, j'ai accepté la démission de Mme Payette. Ce matin, j'ai eu une conversation téléphonique avec Sa Majesté la Reine et je l'ai informé que le juge en chef du Canada remplira les fonctions de gouverneur général de façon intérimaire. Une recommandation concernant un remplaçant sera présentée en temps et lieu. Monday will mark a year since the first recorded case of COVID-19 in Canada. If you're tired and fed up, that's understandable. But remember, this is not forever. With vaccines being rolled out, we're in the final stretch. Canada is approaching 750,000 vaccine doses administered across the country. And on average, the number of doses done daily is now almost 4 times more than what it was just 3 weeks ago. In other words, we're getting more vaccines delivered and delivered quicker, and these doses are getting out to more and more people. Yesterday, I spoke with the global CEO of Pfizer, Dr. Bourla. The next few weeks will be challenging when it comes to deliveries. That said, Dr. Bourla assured me that hundreds of thousands of Pfizer doses will be delivered the week of February 15th and in the weeks to follow. He also confirmed that we will receive all of our 4 million doses from Pfizer before March 31st. The current momentary delay is so that they can increase their production overall going forward. I'll also add that we'll get almost 500,000 Moderna doses in February, too. We're working around the clock to get as many vaccines as we can, as fast as we can. It's what I'm thinking about when I wake up in the morning, when I go to bed, and every hour in between. Au moment où on se parle, le gouvernement fédéral travaille avec tous les ordres de gouvernement pour accélérer les efforts de vaccination. On a déjà livré 1,1 million de doses de vaccins contre la COVID-19 aux provinces et aux territoires. Et au printemps, on s'attend à ce qu'au moins 20 millions de doses soient déployées. J'ai abordé le sujet hier avec les premiers ministres des provinces et des territoires lors de notre 25e rencontre des premiers ministres. Je sais que les premiers ministres veulent obtenir plus de doses le plus tôt possible. C'est ma priorité aussi. On maintient le cap pour offrir un vaccin à tous les Canadiens qui souhaitent se faire vacciner d'ici septembre. At my 25th meeting with the premiers yesterday, we also talked about border and travel. My message to Canadians remains clear. If no one should be taking a vacation abroad right now, if you've got one planned, cancel it. And don't book a trip for spring break. It's obvious we should avoid trips south and out of the country. But remember, across the country, people are being told to stay home. So if you were thinking of traveling across the country for spring break, now's not the time. We need to hang on and hold tight for the next few months. We must get through to the spring and mass vaccinations in the best shape possible. Les mesures que le Canada applique pour les voyages et les frontières sont parmi les plus strictes au monde. Elles comprennent notamment un test de dépistage obligatoire avant le retour au pays, et les États-Unis suivent maintenant notre exemple, ainsi qu'une quarantaine obligatoire de 2 semaines. Avec nos nouvelles mesures, il y a maintenant moins de vols. Mais comme je l'ai dit au premier ministre, on est prêt à prendre des mesures encore plus strictes s'il le faut. Ensemble, on a discuté de la gamme d'options sur la table présentement, parce que quand il est question de sécurité, on n'exclut aucune possibilité. Alors qu'on travaille avec les provinces et les territoires pour mener à bien la campagne de vaccination et appliquer les mesures frontalières, on apporte également un soutien supplémentaire à nos ressources en soins de santé. Comme j'en ai discuté avec les premiers ministres, on doit s'assurer de ne pas rouvrir trop tôt durant cette deuxième vague. Les gouvernements provinciaux ont déjà pris des décisions difficiles mais nécessaires et le nombre de cas a diminué dans certaines régions du pays. Notre gouvernement sera toujours là pour les provinces et les territoires lorsqu'il s'agit d'assurer la sécurité des gens. The spike in COVID-19 cases this month has put a real strain on hospitals. For Ontario in particular, the situation is extremely serious. When we spoke last week, I told Premier Ford we would be there to support Ontario with any assistance they need. Keeping you and your family safe is our top priority. That's why our government is deploying 2 federal mobile health units to the GTA. This will provide up to 200 additional hospital beds and free up space for people who need ICU care. Each of the units can also provide vital medical equipment and supplies. Of course, right across the country, we're also doing our part on testing. We've sent 14.3 million rapid tests to the front lines, with millions more on the way. Everyone should have access to a fast, reliable test when they need one. Finally, the premiers and I discussed the new administration in the United States. We had a great Team Canada approach with the previous administration, and that's something that will continue to serve us well. During our conversation, the premiers and I talked about the United States' decision on the Keystone XL pipeline. I am, of course, disappointed with this choice. To workers, especially in Alberta and Saskatchewan, who've been hit hard, we will continue to have your backs. We will always stand up for good Canadian jobs. Canadians and Americans are more than just neighbours. We are allies, partners, and friends. Together, we've faced some of the greatest challenges the world has ever seen. So I know that we're ready to work shoulder to shoulder to defeat COVID-19 and rebuild economies that work for everyone. This is something I look forward to discussing with President Biden when we speak on the phone later today. Je sais que le président Biden et moi, on est sur la même longueur d'onde à propos de la lutte contre les changements climatiques, de l'importance de créer de bons emplois pour la classe moyenne et de la nécessité de bâtir un monde plus pacifique et plus stable. Depuis longtemps, les Canadiens et les Américains font front commun face aux défis et aux changements. Ensemble, je sais que nous pouvons continuer à améliorer la vie des gens des deux côtés de notre frontière. Finally, I want to end this morning by recognizing that this will be an especially tough day for the people in La Loche, Saskatchewan. To everyone who lost someone, to the survivors, to the entire community, you are in our thoughts and in our hearts. I met many of you when I visited La Loche and spoke with students and teachers and community members. Your strength and courage is remarkable. In the last 5 years, we've worked together on new programs and resources for your school and funded cultural and language-based programs, on-the-land activities, and mental health services for students. But I want you to know today, we will continue to be there for you. Today and always, Canada stands with you. It's just who we are. People across this country stand there for each other when times are difficult. And we will continue to be there for you. Merci beaucoup.